Yeah. Got a little story to tell today.
Sounds like a love song. Sounds like
I'm gonna like this one. It's gonna be a hit one day. Watch. Shout out to everybody. I lost a family member after a hard day of work. It was fun. It's hard living without another parent. You only got one. You gotta do what you gotta do. I'm a young kid with no present father figure. Doing what I want cause nothing's ever been realer. I ain't stupid so I'm doing nothing bad. But at the same time, I'm being watched over by my dad. Yeah, my dad's in heaven. We were all in a car accident around 11. The story might seem a little intensive, so here we go, I'ma say everything that was ever mentioned. It was July 15, 2006. Me, my dad, my stepmom, and the kid. We were driving home from Wildwood from a chill date. My stepmom asked my dad, can we go home? It's getting real late. Kids had a lot of fun and I have a headache. But see, that's where it all started. Cause my dad wanted to stay. But I called him and said, hey, dad, let's just go. We had enough on for today. She left my dad, started crazy. Well, now my stepmom is Spanish, so I had no clue. But I knew it wasn't good once I saw his hand flew. Flaring in the air like you're playing ping pong. And when we stopped, my stepmom said, Matt, you should have been the phone. I was a little nervous because I was only 12. And when my dad seen the door, it opened back to the fail. He came out, got back in, and said, buckle up. After that, remember, it was just a light, quick rush. I fell asleep and dozed off, up into my own world. But I remember waking up to the swerving from a squirrel. At least that's what he said. So I went back into the sleep like I was dead. Dreaming about who knows what, maybe making bread. I'm getting woke up from the screen. Abraham, I woke up wondering what's going on. The cop to my right and my dad on the horn. People all surrounded me in this letter of horn. I'm asking what happened, everything was alright. I could've sworn that I'm told you were in the accident. But the mind is all worn, so the cop hunted me out. Even though I didn't wanna, I said I'm staying here with my dad, man. I'm just gunning. But when I got out, my body ached and spit all bloody. Got up in the ambulance with two buddies. They took me, kept me safe, they rushed me. And when I arrived, they called my mom and said, man, this son is lucky. Everyone else had life-threatening situations. I'd like for you to come in so I can give you an explanation. 3 days later, my mom is bloody from this occurrence. But when my mom came in, I could see something wrong from her appearance. Walked in, face full of tears, saying, I'm sorry, honey. But you know I'm always here, even when it's time to turn me. I started crying as well, not fully understanding. And she said, your dad passed away, and too much damage. Feeling like I'm dreaming, not fully comprehending. I said I want to detail the entire explanation. And she tells me what happened, explaining all other injuries. I sit back and shout out and say, God, why you have to do this to me? You took a man, I was just getting ready to know. A man who turned his life around, but only you would know. I feel like I did something wrong from this unlucky glow. People always saying I'm sorry, like you're the one who took them through those pearly gates. That's something I imagine about every day. Wondering when will my time come, is mine to be the day. Crying over a stone in the cemetery, thinking to myself, you were too quick to be buried. Only 38 years old, I guess God was in a hurry. But I learned you can't blame the man upstairs. You just gotta stay down here and handle theirs. The only child for my dad, so I watch over my grandma and wipe her tears. My mother also in the hope to grow up to be handsome. People say I look just like him, just like my dad. And as days pass, I wonder and think about what I had. So now the court try to settle to give me just a couple grand. Like any money will ever replace my dad. Or you can't, stuck in the world listening to some man. He has a plan, doing really, he's a fucking bad man. But it's like the first day, can't do a goddamn thing. But once I heard the man who did it would get away, my mind was boggled and thoughts were all up in displaced. Thinking to myself, this can't be happening, no way. He has to go to jail for the things that he created. Had my stepmom bleeding all up by the brain. She was like a vegetable, man, she couldn't say a thing. But what really affected me is she was the only witness. But thanks to the accident, she don't even remember crashing. And the worst part, she thinks my dad was her ex-husband. She had to learn how to be right and how to think. To this day, I said she has trouble seeing, but she will win. And that's just for her son, he got all torn up, said it wasn't fun. Had a neck brace and some spine injuries in one. She came out of camp, something I've even become. I was all good, just an internal injury. I really felt like I had God standing right next to me. But back to the court decision, it was the worst. Wondering how was this happening if he was drunk. I guess the government system really all corrupt. Being paid off just laid to rest. Then I heard in the car, they sound some fucking Percocets. God damn.